Hello friends, today we are going to see how to find a number in an array which occurs for odd number of times. So let's see, this is the array and there is one number in the array which occurs odd number of times. So how to find out that? One method is that you have to count the number of times occurrence of each number. Means, for example, you can make a hash table. So, and in the hash table, you can say the key is the number and how many times it is occurring is the value. So, 1 is occurring 1, 2, 3, 4. 1 is occurring 4 times. Then 5 is occurring 2 times. Then again 1 is there, so it is already noted. Then 2 is occurring how many times? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Yes, so 2 is the number, 2 is the number which occurs odd number of times in the array. Here there are two steps. First step is that you have to count the number of occurrences of that key, means that element in the array, and the second step is that you have to check whether that number of occurrence, that is for example 4 or 2 or 5, is odd or not. So out of 4 to 5, 5 is odd, so 2 is occurring odd number of times. So this is one method. But this method is inefficient in space because you consume an extra space for the hash table. So is there any other method which does not use this space but gives us the number occurring odd number of times in the same time complexity, means in the most efficient way? So the method is by using XOR operation. So the basis of this is that you can see here in the XOR table, if the same element is XORed with itself, means A XOR A, the answer will be 0. Means when the same element we XOR with itself, then the answer is 0. And if we XOR an element with 0, then that element itself is the answer. So this principle we are going to use here. So the idea is that suppose I do A XOR B XOR A XOR B C, then obviously A and A, they will cancel each other because A XOR A, it is like addition operation. You have to perform like addition operation. Even if A is here and another A is after B, but you can treat this XOR operation like addition operation. So you can XOR A and this A. So they cancel because A XOR A is 0. So 0 XOR B, and the remaining is XOR B. Again this is cancelling and 0 XOR 0 is 0. This means in this example or in this series of XORs, there is no element which is occurring odd number of times. Now if I add one more XOR operation and I write A here, then you can see this A will cancel with this A. Then we will have 0 XOR B XOR B and XOR the remaining A. Then this B is cancelling with this B is cancelling with this B. So 0 XOR 0 and the remaining A. And now 0 XOR A. This 0 XOR 0 is 0. 0 XOR A will be A. So because A is occurring odd number of times, that is 3 times, the final answer is that element which is occurring odd number of times. Means final answer is A. So we can say that A is occurring odd number of times. That is the principle we are going to use here. So let's solve the example now. This is the array and we have to find out the number which is occurring odd number of times in this array. So let's XOR all the elements. Means we have to apply XOR operation between all the elements in the array. Okay. Means we have to XOR all the elements. So when we XOR them, then obviously this 1 will cancel with this 1. And 5 will cancel with 5. 2 will cancel with this 2. 3 will cancel with this 3. Then 4 will cancel with this 4. 1 will cancel here. 2 will cancel. And 2, yes. This 2 is not cancelling with anyone. Means the last element which remains in the array is the element which occurs odd number of times in the array. Remember, you can use this method only when there is only one element in the array which is occurring odd number of times. Because if more than one element occurs odd number of times, for example, there is an extra element in this array, that is 4, then 2 and 4. So your final answer will be XOR of 2 and 4. So that will be something X, for example, 2X or 4 is X. Then you cannot reverse engineer it to find out the elements. Means from the answer X, you cannot reverse engineer to find out what XOR it is. So if there is only one element which is occurring odd number of times, then this method works very efficiently. Hey friends, please subscribe to my channel as I post algorithm videos every day. And if you want a video on any particular topic, then please mention in the comment below. Thank you.